Lance Mechanics here today, and if your alternator looks like this, we gotta have a talk. So, if you're watching the video or you clicked on the thumbnail, you're probably wondering what's going on. This is an alternator off a transverse engine, and I want you to go look outside at your alternator. If your alternator looks like this and it's encrusted in oil, you're gonna hate me. It's Murphy's Law. Once you know about it, it's gonna fail. And once I've always told customers, once they're alternator is covered in oil, it's gonna fail. They don't believe me. A week later, it comes back on with a battery light. So don't hate me. I'm sorry. So originally, I was gonna talk about oil contamination and how it will always cause an alternator to fail. And then it kind of evolved into something else. And it came to a realization that all the alternators I replaced were on transverse engines. And what that means, this is an example of not a transverse engine. What a transverse engine is it runs from here this way, and it usually has a transmission that reverses around and goes out the back. That's for all-wheel drive models or front-wheel drive. This is a longitude engine, transmissions that way. But it came to the realization that a transverse engine always costs more to maintain in the long run. And a lot of factors come into that. When you have a transverse engine, you're putting more, wear and tear on it. It's in a tighter area. The cost of everything shoots up. And it's just a very bad layout for an engine. You can take the same engine and put it longitudinally down the center of the vehicle, and it will not have the same failure rates as a transverse engine. And you can see this in Toyota, maybe not Honda, Toyota, Ford, any of the manufacturers that make SUVs. They take that same engine, they put it in a pickup, and it does not have the same failure rates that a transverse engine does. So my Jeep Gladiator is not a good example of this. Rearward facing engine, forward, whatever you want to say, longitudinal. The alternator is put here for a reason, for water treading, and it's put up here so it's not in the lower area of the components. But my example is, when an engine is facing this way, it has less failure rates. It gets better airflow, it gets better cleaning. And what happens is, I find on a lot of these transverse engines, the valve cover leaks. And for obvious reasons, they place all these components right under the valve covers, because they're trying to save space. And what happens is, that increases the cost of repairs. So let's take a Toyota Camry with a 3.5 liter. This is a 2024. That alternator on a Toyota Camry is 3.5 hours to replace. But you put the same engine in a Tacoma and that alternator is 1.1 hours. So not only do you get increased failure rates in a transverse engine, you also get increased labor rates. So if you don't know, I do all these videos unedited in one shot. I just hit pause and play on my phone. So this is pretty raw. As I was doing this video, it was for something else, and then I came to the sad realization that over my career, from working at the private garage to the dealers, is compact SUVs or SUVs in general with a transverse engine layout costs more in the long run to maintain. They have failures like no other vehicle in the same lineup. So what I'm saying is, you take that same engine and put it in a truck platform and it will not have the same failures. There's something about the layout, the heat, the cycles, what it's being used for that just cause these things to become money pits. And the more I think about it, SUVs and compact SUVs are the biggest money pits of this era. I'm doing a video on the suspension in the rear that might shock people. That'll come out. It's going to be, do you want tire wear or your life? It's kind of interesting. But the more and more I think about it, my biggest repair estimates have always been on SUVs. A $6,000 to $10,000 estimate is not uncommon for me these days, and comes down to components on the drivetrain, the serpentine belts, valve covers leaking. It just snowballs. Like that alternator, I hate to say it, once you notice your alternator is covered in oil, it will fail. I've seen this at Honda all the time. Valve covers leak onto it, or the valve solenoid pack. And a simple oil leak turns into a $3,200 repair by the time you pull the valve cover, remove the cams, replace the valve solenoid pack, replace the alternator. And the customers who decline the alternator are always back a week later. I refuse to clean the area up with any kind of solvent, because that is a guaranteed comeback. They will be back the next day, if not that day. And those alternators are not cheap. And it's just something you learn over time. Transverse engines, in my opinion, are the biggest money dump on the market. And this is going to take some chiming in from mechanics too, because as I mentioned, the labor rates, once you put an engine the opposite way, almost triple, if not quadruple, to get at things. Simple little things, as I mentioned in my previous video, alternator, serpentine belts, pulleys. You're trying to do sensors on the back of the engine now. Everything triples in price just to do this. So the person who plans on buying a used vehicle or keeping these longer than 5 years or outside the warranty, I recommend buying an extended warranty. And you got to plan down the road. Do you plan on having a family when you buy these vehicles? Because 8 years down the road, things change. And these vehicles, I laugh because you see something like a compact SUV or midsize SUV, they'll be like something like $2,700 to $3,500 a year in fuel. Or you buy the truck, it's $3,800 a year in fuel, and then it goes up. Well, the repairs you're going to pay down the road kind of balance each other out. Would you have been better off with a truck or the compact SUV? That's hard to say. I'll rely on a lot of people in the comments. This is just an opinion based on what I've seen in the northern climate of Canada, where we have extreme failures on components. And my personal opinion is transverse engine layouts are money pits, at least up here in the north. See what you think. It's Lance Mechanics, just another opinion. Have a great day.